You know, one of the things that we want to help people understand is how the Earth got its shape. Mm-hmm. Geologists like to use a word called geomorphology. And as a flood geologist, I think a lot of that shaping actually took place after the flood was over.
Well, we've talked a lot about the deformation of those layers, the soft bending, right, and so forth, but this is something different. John, it seems to me that we're in the middle of a layer. What is this?
Our delta. This side used to connect to that side and everything in between. So there's a lot of rock that's been removed in here.
Yeah.
So let's start with where the rock layer itself came from. I think this layer was made during Noah's flood. I've studied this rock layer in some detail down in Arizona, the Coconino sandstone, called the Weber up here. The layer extends all the way from California up to the Dakotas. And so this used to be solid across here. There was, you know, no canyon here. This rock layer went all the way across. And my suspicion is this canyon has been cut by some catastrophe in the years after the flood. We see this in Grand Canyon, and we saw it at Mount St. Helens, and we see it here too, that you see these relatively small streams in relatively large valleys or large canyons. Even the biggest river we have in the United States, the Mississippi, even though it's a mile wide in places, it sits in a valley that's 100 miles wide. And we call those underfit streams, underfit valleys, or underfit canyons. And it means that the river flowing through them does not quite match the immense size of the valley of a canyon. My guess is 90% of the canyons and valleys around the world are underfit. And so we think that as mountains were lifted up, and as erosion started to work on those mountains in the form of flash floods, in the form of mud flows, in the form of glaciation and so on, a lot of those processes could work on canyons like this and enlarge them pretty quickly.
John, it seems, at least to me, to say that all the things that carved this canyon out don't seem to be happening today. What's your take?
Yeah, and that's kind of a principle that I think is pretty true in geomorphology, is that a landscape goes through major changes, catastrophically, maybe like one night at Mount St. Helens,
yeah,
and then the landscape just sits there until the next catastrophe. And so it's not that we don't have any catastrophes today, but I think the number of catastrophes that we have is declining from the large number of catastrophic events that we would have had as these mountains lifted up.
You've mentioned that post-flood era, that there was a tremendous amount of precipitation.
Yeah.
And so an area like this, it doesn't really get a whole lot of rain.
That's right.
It was a drastically different climate at that time.
It was. Just to the north of here in Fossil Basin and Green River Basin, we've looked at, you know, the lush landscape that was there, the amount of vegetation that had to grow there, and the water that was there. And it's much different from the climate that we have here today.
I think from my perspective, as a geologist, climate change is the rule, not the exception. It's something that's been going on ever since the flood was over.